Many people suffer from bad digestion simply because they don't follow the rules of the stomach. Yes, today we are going to learn about the rules of the stomach. The stomach is a vital part of the digestive system. It operates under several key rules or functions. Number one, storage. The stomach serves as a reservoir for food, allowing it to be stored temporarily after ingestion until it is digested enough to leave the stomach and enter the small intestine. Number two, digestion. The digestive glands in your stomach lining produce hydrochloric acid and enzymes which mix with the food and break it down until it forms a murky semi-fluid mass or a paste which is called chyme. Food is not supposed to leave the stomach until it is in this semi-fluid state called chyme. Number three, killing pathogens. The highly acidic environment of the stomach, created by the hydrochloric acid, kills bacteria and pathogens, thus serving as a protective mechanism against infections. Number four, controlled emptying. The food is emptied from the stomach into the small intestine when it reached a certain degree of liquidity. So remember, it must be in this semi-fluid state called chyme. If the food leaves the stomach too soon, the following digestive processes cannot execute efficiently. The pyloric sphincter at the bottom of the stomach is a muscular valve that opens to allow the food to pass from the stomach to the top of the small intestine. This happens as soon as the food has reached this certain degree of liquidity. The walls of the small intestine contains muscles that contract and relax to mix and propel the chyme along, allowing for thorough digestion and absorption. By the time the chyme reaches the end of the small intestine, most of the nutrients have already been absorbed and leaving only the waste products to continue into the large intestine for further processing before elimination. The process completes the next morning when the waste is excreted. Now, let us consider the first rule of the stomach. Rule number one, avoid consuming liquids with your meal, except for a small glass of wine. If you are thirsty, drink water at least 30 minutes before eating and wait at least half an hour after your meal before having any liquids. Why? Drinking liquids during your meals can interrupt the digestive process in the stomach. When the pyloric sphincter evaluates the stomach's contents, it detects a liquid and it opens up to allow the material to move into the small intestine, even if the rest of the food is not digested or in the correct stage. Now, pushing this undigested food into the small intestine poses problems on two fronts. First of all, the pathogens within the food remain uneliminated. And secondly, the food isn't prepared for the next digestive phase because it's not digested enough. These undigested particles, alongside the bacteria, might harm the intestinal lining and contribute to mucoid plaque formation. Over time, this might lead to a condition known as a leaky gut. A leaky gut occurs when the tight junctions between the cells in the intestinal lining are compromised. This facilitates the passage of undigested food, toxins, and bacteria into the bloodstream. This influx can trigger an immune response and lead to inflammation. Another issue pertains to hydrochloric acid. The generation of hydrochloric acid commences upon the arrival of food in the stomach and ceases when the food departs from the stomach. Insufficient retention of the food in the stomach deprives it of the necessary time to generate hydrochloric acid. If this occurrence becomes habitual, the stomach may develop a reluctance to produce hydrochloric acid, ultimately leading to a loss of this vital capability. Another concern related to hydrochloric acid involves salt. Salt stands out as the prime supplier of chloride, and maintaining sufficient chloride levels is crucial for the synthesis of hydrochloric acid. Dr. Sivers has created multiple videos emphasizing the significance of incorporating salt into one's diet and dispelling the misconception that it leads to high blood pressure. He is a MD, PhD, and his assertions are substantiated by robust scientific evidence and research. I encourage you to view his videos on the subject of salt. Salt also supports the rules of the stomach. The stomach needs salt to produce hydrochloric acid, which is needed to digest food. Dr. Sivers say you can never eat too much salt. Rule number 2. Wait for the process to complete before starting another process. The digestive cycle commences upon food consumption and culminates in the waste elimination. Most of these processes take place at night, and the culmination occurs during the morning excretion. It is very important to wait for this completion before eating again. Rushing into your next meal before defecation prompts the digestive system to abandon its ongoing process and redirecting all its energy towards the new food intake. This abrupt shift can congest the digestive system and leading to constipation. Adhering to the stomach's schedule holds immense significance, believe it or not. The digestive system serves as the linchpin for your overall health, with many chronic diseases believed to originate in the digestive system. Optimal digestive function significantly bolsters your overall health and well-being and plays a pivotal role in averting diseases. Thank you for watching my video. I sincerely appreciate your time. Please help me to grow this channel by hitting the like and subscribe and the bell buttons. You can also share this information with your family and your friends. My name is Anna.